Actually, chemotherapy and hormone therapies during pregnancy can have an effect on the developing fetus. So it is advisable that the patient is not on any chemotherapy or hormone therapies when she is actually planning for the pregnancy. With conventional ovarian stimulation regimes have been discouraged by many oncologists to be contraindicated for use in patients with breast cancer. But with the advent of newer ovarian stimulation regimens using aromatase inhibitors like tamoxifen and letrozole, they have given the ART specialist good advantage of obtaining good number of oocytes and embryos for cryopreservation in patients with breast cancer, where they have been able to keep the estradiol levels low during the stimulation. There is no proof that breastfeeding actually increases the chances of recurrence in a woman with breast cancer following a pregnancy. There is enough evidence also to show that, in fact, breastfeeding reduces the chances of a recurrence in a patient with breast cancer following a pregnancy. There are no established guidelines as to how long the woman should wait before considering a pregnancy. But patients who are at a very high risk of recurrence, waiting till the completion of adjuvant therapy is advisable. Some people suggest waiting for up to 6 months before the completion of chemotherapy, whereas many of them actually wait for a period of 2 years once they have completed their treatment before they actually plan to get pregnant. A number of young adults actually start to dream of becoming parents once they are cured of cancer. And as a result of cancer therapies, they have a lot of chronic adverse effects on their gonads, causing infertility. This causes a lot of low self-esteem and depression amongst young adults.